Oh, Ha 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 ha! Huh. What is this place?
Thank you. Ha ha ha! Yeah. Imbecile. That's what he calls Professor Blanchard. The imbecile is choosing two students to lead a research assignment in an abandoned farmhouse. Carter knows he's going to be selected. He's the best in the neuroscience program. The best at the Leary. The Leary. It could only be the Leary. The Leary or the Allen. Two institutions with a history of working with the government to push the limits of psychology beyond the code. Not beyond the code, despite the code. The papers coming out of the Allen amazed him, captured him, inspired him. Had he been Canadian, it would have been the Allen, or what many called Ravenscrag. The experiments they conducted were brilliant, cutting edge, mind-shattering. He wishes he were a student in the 50s studying under Lord Crag, the nickname patients gave the genius at Ravenscrag. Lord Crag returned from the trials with ideas, not cautionary tales, not disgust like the other bleeding hearts who condemned the doctors who would anyway be smuggled into his country and be given the highest positions in government in exchange for their discoveries. Lord Crag took the experiments he had heard about to the next level, and Carter... Carter hopes to do the same. But not with this professor, not with Blanchard, Dr. Blanchard, Dr. Bleeding Heart Blanchard. He has no idea what real power is. Real power is freedom. True freedom. Freedom beyond the limits of ethics and morality. Carter's leading the research assignment with another peer. The challenge? Secure the secret word through the good doctor, bad doctor interrogation technique put forward by some other bleeding heart imbecile at some other institution. He's bad doctor. A list of do's and don'ts the imbecile gave him. Very limiting. Too limiting. Self-limiting even. How is he supposed to secure anything with these limits? Surely he realizes how futile the experiment is with this code. Nevertheless, he tries. He shouts at a fellow student sitting across the table from him. Shouts? Big deal. Tell me or I'll... shout again. The student doesn't take him seriously. He's play-acting fear. It's all make-belief for him. I should smash his skull and yank the secret word out of his substandard mediocre brain.